I think part of the precipitating thing that caused knitting to catch my fancy, to get me really excited about it, was the moment, and it really was almost a moment, when I realized that I actually did understand the structure of how the fabric went together. My mom is a big knitter and sort of general fiber artist, I suppose, and she taught me to knit rather optimistically when I was probably 3 or 4, and unsurprisingly, I didn't care that much at that age. And she gave it another try a few years later. I want to say I was maybe 8 or 9, and at that point, it kind of stuck. It's cool to be able to, you know, take a pile of string and 2 sticks and turn it into something. There's something really rewarding about that. Once I got to the point that I could do at least sort of straightforward patterns without having to look at it, that was definitely a big jump in terms of being able to have a face-to-face conversation, knit in a meeting and still pay attention, knit in a classroom, knit while watching TV. Most of the time, if I'm sitting and not otherwise engaged with my hands in some way, I'll often be knitting or thinking about knitting. It helps me sort of focus my fidgety energy, I think. Even back in middle and high school, I would be the kid who was knitting in class, and my mom was very adamant. She's like, the beginning of the year, you have to go and ask the teacher if it's okay. My first job was actually as a clerk in my local knitting store. I grew up in a suburb of Rochester, New York. On the weekends, I would work a couple hours a day restocking shelves and helping people find things. And it was fun, and I think people were often surprised that someone that young was pretty knowledgeable and could point them in the right direction when they asked advice about things. My mom and I would often, you know, as we'd acquired enough piles of things that we'd made without particular purpose in mind, we would put together little sales. At our synagogue back in the day, there used to be like a Hanukkah craft market thing. We would sell things and basically just keep money to recoup the cost of the supplies and then pick some charity to donate the rest to. So I remember we raised money for our local humane society at home. I used to volunteer for a hospice house in high school, so we donated some money to them. So it's a cool way to use that to kind of give back in some way. So my husband is Professor Jerry Wong in the Civil Environmental Engineering Department, and we got married this past April, on April Fool's Day actually, at the National Aviary, which is really one of our favorite places in the area, and so it was tremendously special to be able to get married there. We put a lot of thought into making the ceremony and the whole event really reflect us and our personalities and our values. My knitting as a hobby is something that a lot of people know about me, and so being able to incorporate that in some way was a special and exciting idea. What I ended up doing was knitting little bird centerpieces for each of the tables at the reception. So I found patterns for a bunch of different kinds of birds. I'm also a spinner, which is a really neat way to learn one step back in the process. Not only how do I make yarn into socks or hats or sweaters, but also how does the yarn get made in the first place? And that's a really neat thing to learn, and spinning is its own kind of, you know, maybe not as portable. I can't necessarily bring it and use my spinning wheel in a meeting, but it's its own kind of meditative thing that can be really, really pleasant when I'm sitting at home watching TV or something like that. So I wouldn't say that knitting necessarily directly relates to my particular research work, but I think there's a lot of really cool connections to material science and engineering generally, and those kinds of principles. A big theme in material science is sort of understanding materials at many length scales, right? So understanding both down at the atomistic level and at the so-called mesoscale or microscale, all the way up to the sort of continuum level of a piece of material or some sort of part or object that I can hold and use for something. And I think knitting is actually a really great embodiment of that. I'm hoping to give a summer seminar in the department this summer entitled something along the lines of Knitting, the OG Additive Manufacturing.